Ritik, which eye do I look into? Right eye or left eye?
Whether as Ananya, whether as Supriya, whether as Bulbul, Mrunal Thakur has always lit up every single screen, no matter where we see her. And Jaggu and I are so pleased, so honored and so delighted that she's here to light up the screen for you and us. Mrunal Thakur, the most punctual heroine in the world, is already here on So Far So Good. Mrunal, we are so pleased to welcome you on our show.
Hey, so happy to be here.
And we're fully familiar with your schedule for today, and we're so pleased that you even then managed to take our time. So thank you very much.
You know, I had to do this, and I'm really excited to do this because, you know, Taranadi is a friend, and Jaggu, you and Taranadi, you both rock.
Aww.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And please know that the feeling is mutual.
But okay, so I keep wanting to call you little one. I want to call you Bulbul. I want to call, because, well, Mrunal calls me Didi because my mother is a Dadi to her, or another mother to her, and thinks of Mrunal as a little one. And for as long as she's known my mother, which is, I think, over almost 10 years now, she's called me Didi, and which is why she is here. And Bobby, matlab seedha flight se utarte, she's like, haan, Didi, I am there. Anything for you and Jaggu. So, thank you, my love. And we must ask you.
Thank you.
Listen, Tufan, what an amazing film. What an amazing job you've done. And I was, you know, every time you come on screen, people have been saying you light it up. It's true, because we see you smile and then automatically there's a smile on your face. And then when we see you not smiling and upset, then you're feeling like you're really feeling it. And I think that's what an actor desires, right? For the audience to feel it. Are you feeling good about yourself in Tufan?
You know, the best compliment I have gotten till date is when, you know, my mom said that when Ananya was smiling, we were smiling. When Ananya was crying, we were crying. And when Ananya, anything wrong happened to her, with her, our heart literally sank. And that was my biggest achievement, I think, as an actor. For my mom, when she watches me, she doesn't watch that character as Mrunal. She watches that character as the character, you know, as Ananya. So I think that was my biggest achievement. And she's my biggest critic. So I was very happy to hear that from her. And I felt so good. I can't tell you. I felt like I won an award itself.
Wow.
Aww.
No, it's that thing, right? You can watch a film or you can feel a film. And often enough for the audience, you don't consciously know when that switch has happened. But at the end, in hindsight, you realize, wow, maza aaya. And that's you. That's what you manage to create so often.
Thank you, Jaggu. See, like, this is what we'll... Like, I'm so happy, first of all, that we released the movie in this middle of this pandemic, after second wave. And although the film was made for theaters, but we came out on OTT. And I felt like this was the time where the audience really needed to watch something where they could feel it. You know, not just to watch, to get entertained, but, you know, also be motivated. And I felt like this was like the perfect film with perfect combination. It has celebration, it has sports, it has emotions, it has this, although it's a sports drama or sport based on sports, but there is this cute love story, lovely love story, you know, the chemistry between Aziz and Ananya. I fell in love with Ananya and Aziz, you know, and I felt like audience really needed a film like Tufan. And like you mentioned, I needed a film where I could feel it and not just watch it for the heck of or to get entertained.
No, and it's actually worked. Yeah, no, and it's worked that it was an OTT release because you were suddenly in our living room. So it's you know, like how television is a medium of close-ups and it's in your living
room.
It reaches hearts. And now films which are like a larger than life experience, suddenly an emotional film, it works, you know, when it is released on OTT. So Tufan has rocked. We have, of course, watched it akele akele. You have seen your movie sitting next to Shah Rukh Khan.
Yes, I did. I didn't really speak about it before because we ended up showing him 3-4 weeks before the film released. So we were not supposed to talk about it. But I think this is the first time on your interview I'm talking about watching the movie with Shah Rukh Khan. And he's like, you know, I think one of the reasons why I am in this industry is because of him. And I always kept telling myself, like, if Shah Rukh Khan can make that transition from TV to films, why can't I? If Vidya Ma'am could do that, why can't I? So watching the movie, it was the first time I was watching the final cut. And having him next to us was like a dream come true. And I kept counting the number of times he hugged me and he said, "Mrunal, you've done a great job."
Wow.
And I felt like I was in a different world altogether. But I will never, ever, ever forget that day. He's one of the most humble and kind heart human I have ever met. I was in love with him, but I think I fell in love all the way more when I met him.
No, I know he's one of your favorite actors. So you must have been completely like, oh my God, should I pinch myself? Is this really happening? Is he sitting right next to me and smiling and looking at me and saying, good job? What a surreal moment. You'll never forget it, no?
Never, ever. Tarana, when I reached home, my father got me a box of Kaju Katli.
And yeah, baby. Said,
this is your this is your achievement. My parents go to bed by 10:30, 11 max. Yeah. That day, because it got a little late, I reached home by midnight and they all were awake and waiting for me. There was this little panchayat there happening. And I was explaining them how it was and what he said. And he's such a down-to-earth person, such a sweetheart who came to drop me till my car and was... I feel like I'm really blessed that, wow, you know, I got to meet him. I got a chance to sit with him and watch the movie. And when he was I just kept telling him, I want to work with you. And he said, inshallah, one day soon.
Fantastic.
And I can't wait for that day.
We do.
Listen, you know, you spoke about the transition from television to film. And from what little I know of the background, you've also done theater from very young. Of course, everybody knows you from television right in the beginning. You've done a string of now fabulous movies, but also in two languages, Marathi as well as Hindi, which is a fabulous trajectory to have. How does Indonesia fit into all of this? Just explain to me. I didn't get it. You've done the Indonesian Nagin version and a couple of other things.
Yeah, Jagu, because there was a time in my life where... I was stereotyped being a television actor and I needed to break that. Also, I needed a break. I needed to explore. And there was an opportunity where my show Kum Kum Bhagya was aired in Indonesia. It's called Lonchan Chinta. So it got really popular. Like how we screen a show for around 30 minutes a day, but there it would be screening like a movie, like for 2 hours, 4 episodes straight.
Wow.
So popularity grew and there was a time where I quit television and I was supposed to be on a movie film set, but that film didn't work out. So this opportunity came and I feel like every opportunity is golden. Of this opportunity, I got to learn Bahasa Indonesia and I love learning different languages. I like to travel. I like to explore different cultures. So I think this was a great opportunity for me. Like people, you know, that image that was formed, like TV image, it also faded off. And then when I got back after two and a half years, I got back, Love Sonia. And that literally changed my career, the way people looked at me, the way they perceived me. And I think that one small difference I could make was people didn't call me a television actress. People called me Indian actress, which was like my biggest achievement.
Absolutely.
But it's really
hard. You
made the
transition successfully.
But it is hard, right? I know this as someone who's done TV, that very few people from television are actually given opportunities to work in film. And I'm hoping, you know, people like Vidya Balan, Sushant Singh Rajput, of course, and you now will pave the way for more people to... Because an actor is an actor, you know. And I like no actor ever says, I'm a TV actor, I'm a theater actor, I'm a this actor. No, I'm an actor. And I will, wherever, you know, work comes my way, I'm going to try and go there. But it's not been easy in India. So I'm glad it is working out for you. But ye jo strategy hai ke Marathi cinema bhi karenge, Indonesian bhi karenge. Oh, and my debut will be Love Sonia, which was a very hard hitting, very serious movie. Was it thought out, or it was just because the opportunities came your way, ittefaq se sab ho gaya?
Tarana, I manifested it. I had a vision for myself. I still do. And I knew that the only way I could take out that tag, you know, remove that stereotypical tag like TV actor, is by doing different things. Fir kya bolenge? They'll keep adding television actor, Marathi film actor, Bollywood actor, indie film, Hollywood. Kya bolenge? I should just be called, you know, just an actor, right?
Actor. Yeah.
So yeah, and yeah. I think what stays common between me and my work is the camera. The camera doesn't matter. Like now, it doesn't matter if the film is going for OTT, if it is going for theater, it is, you know, a series. It just doesn't matter as long as I'm in front of camera. That was my first thought. Also, my second thought was, if I'm doing a film, it needs to be remembered. It needs to stay evergreen. And that's when Love Sonia happened. And when I heard the story, it was very hard hitting. And I honestly didn't want to do it.
It's scary, right? And you're young.
I was scared. I didn't want to
do it. Scary role, yeah.
And then did you know the cast at that time, or was it not cast at the time? Completely.
No, it was not casted. As I got on board, I then found out that Frida was a part of it. Then I found out Richa was doing the part. And well, I did not know about Demi Moore. I reached LA. We shot the scene with some other actress. And that's when Demi Tabrez, my director, was in touch with Demi Moore. And she said, could I be? So we reshot that scene. And till the end, we did not know that Demi Moore is going to be a part of the film. But I felt like it was a great learning process. I've learned a lot. People say that they start in Bollywood and then go to LA and Hollywood, but I feel like I started ulta. So, and I feel like today I'm more wiser. As not just as an actress, but also as a human. There are so many things that I learned through my job. And I think Love Sonia is going to be that film who's going to be evergreen. And also because it's my baby project, it's my first film.
Yeah.
I did lots and lots of film festivals. I never ever traveled outside India, but this was the first time I got an opportunity to go to New York. We screened the movie at United Nations. We screened the movie for the parliament in Uzbekistan and many countries that I never even heard of. And for me, my agenda was, we faced a lot of problem when it comes to the release of Love Sonia. People were not ready to buy. There were a lot of money which was needed for the PNA, but nobody wanted to invest or sponsor. Then I felt like, you know, this is not going to happen. This is probably the end of my career. I did a film and that's how it's going to be like. But I had faith somewhere. I knew that when this film releases, it's going to have an impact, not just on me as an actor, but also on the society, because it was very well needed. And I'm happy that even after watching this film, my agenda was, even if 5 girls are saved, mission is accomplished.
Absolutely.
And we did end up saving a lot of girls. So this, and I think the reason why I'm in Bollywood, Tarana, is because of Love Sonia. Love Sonia was screened at Melbourne Indian Film Festival, where Nikhil Advani was the jury. And that's where he saw me, and then he casted me.
Cast you for Batla House. Oh, wow. So you've been, there's Love Sonia. Also, the actors that you have been paired opposite are people who a lot of Indian girls have crushes on.
They're hunks. I have crushes on half of them. I mean, Hrithik Roshan, Farhan Akhtar. Yeah. I understand Shahid Kapoor is coming up next. Correct me if I am wrong. John Abraham. Yeah, yeah. I mean, hello. One pot belly. Is that too much to ask for? I mean,
yeah,
look at them.
I mean, like I said, I manifested. I used to have cutouts of Shahid, Hrithik and John in my textbooks, and I always used to get bajar from my father that ye jaate, ye padhai karte ho tum. So I think I feel like I manifested it really hard, and I think I was sincere, you know, मैंने कभी सिंसियरिटी के साथ होमवर्क नहीं किया, लेकिन ये ख्वाहिश थी कि एक दिन आई विल बी विद देम एंड हियर आई एम.
हाउ वंडरफुल.
नो नो लुक, आई हैव टू आस्क यू दिस, ओके, आई एम सॉर्ट ऑफ डाइग्रेसिंग अ लिटिल बिट, बट आई वांट टू कम बैक टू द मैनिफेस्टेशन थिंग. आई नो अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु हैव ट्राइड इट, आई मीन इंक्लूडिंग when the secret came out, it was like a big deal, all of that happened, but I mean, I know it's a more deeper philosophy than you can just pick up from reading a book, however good the book is, but I know very few people, I can't believe I can take another name, I've had a few conversations about this, who have said manifestation worked for me in spades. Just can you run us through your process? And I know I'm taking away from the filmy side of things, but I want to know this.
Jago, people expect things to happen, but they don't realize it that you need to have faith in yourself, because if I'm not going to have faith in myself, no one else would. And if I will not decide for myself, someone else is going to decide for me. So I need to make those decisions. And I feel it is very simple, yeah, Jagu, for, you know how people say, hey, Alexa, play this song or do this for me. Similarly, you have to put those thoughts in your, in the universe, and there are a lot of criticism. I accept it in a positive way. People try to pull you down, and it's society's job to pull you down. How, in spite of all these things, you ab date rehte ho, aur wo date rehna is the most important thing, because there are times where you would like to give up, and when you give up, it means giving a negative energy in the universe. So never ever you should lose faith in yourself, because I think I'm a self-motivator, and I take it in a very positive, like someone discourages me, I'd be like, okay, I'll show you.
Give I'll prove you wrong.
I'll smile. I'll prove you wrong. But I'll not say anything. I'll just meet you and I'll smile.
Point being made. Absolutely.
Yeah.
No, but, it is working. It is working. And you are, I have known you for so many years, and she's always been this positive, cheerful, down-to-earth, warm, loving person. And that kind of energy will always work well in life. You know, it'll, if you're a good person, then good things do happen. And, yeah. and you don't Sarana, remember the realized, bad stuff. Huh?
Yeah, I have learned from Madhu Dadi that is, as an actor, you need to be open to learn things. The day you say, I know, I am aware, I mean, that's the end of, you know, an actor, or it's yeah, their growth. So that's what I learned from Madhu Dadi, and she always kept telling that aap hamesha aapki aapka jo nature hota hai na, as a student ka hona chahiye, be it in life, on set, be it wherever, you should not feel like, when I started my career, I was a very foul mouth, violent, aggressive kid. I used to just overreact. But then,
oh, you were like Tarana.
What Ramesh Jambu?
No! No!
But sorry, finish your thought.
Yeah, but then that's what that thought, you know, you need to learn things. And the curiosity always will take you to heights. I feel like if there is anything, Jagu, that I don't know, be it like stocks, or be it bitcoins, or be it anything about what's happening in Turkey right now, you know, wildlife, anything. I mean, I love to read up. I like to know more about it. You need to keep learning. Be an, as even as an actor, I think the moment an actor says ki mujhe pata hai, maine achha kiya, I think that's the downfall.
The start of the downfall, yeah, for sure.
Once you're done understanding Bitcoin, you explain it to us also.
Yeah.
I'm still trying.
We wanted to do a show on it. We said we don't know what questions to ask.
I have to interject to say, if you, dear viewer, know Bitcoin, this would be a good time to, well, say, I understand Bitcoin, and we will explain to you. Also, please, Nunal is so beautiful. She's been lighting up your screen for all these minutes. Remember to like the video. Remember to subscribe, bell icon, and share this with all her fans. You're the going to make us rock, Nunal. You're such a good girl to do this. Okay. Back to, okay. Okay, there's Shahid. There's Ritik. There's John Abraham. There's Farhan Akhtar. And in various degrees, you must have had a crush on all of them. How was day one of shooting, and how hard was it to be professional and not do a little when you're with them?
Can I touch your bicep? Yeah, so,
Jaggu.
I want to.
This only happened with Hrithik. When I first met Hrithik, he introduced himself, and I was like, why do you need to introduce yourself, first of all? Everybody knows you're Hrithik Roshan. But that's how humble and sweet he is. I remember asking him a very silly question, because I was like, Hrithik, which eye do I look into? Right eye or left eye? And I was very embarrassed. I went back home and I was like, seriously? Like, I was talking to myself, like, who would ask this silly question? He said, you just have to deliver your dialogues. Just see which eye you're comfortable looking at. And I felt so silly.
Well, as long as you didn't say, but they are both so beautiful.
He didn't give you the right answer.
Yeah, no, but they are both so beautiful. Which to say? You didn't say that.
Yeah, you just...
You asked a technical question, Mrunal. It's not a stupid question. It's a good question.
Yeah.
You know, I
have another question.
Yes.
Correct. Fair enough. I have another question. When you were doing a movie with Farhan, with Farhan, did he ever talk about how much Tarana has traumatized him? You acted with him, no?
And I did one scene, Jaggu.
Yeah, but that's enough to traumatize someone.
I will slap you.
It was interesting that when you're talking about the transition, you've made that transition. You're actually one of the people who's made the transition.
Yeah.
So in some way, Mrunal is following your footsteps.
Oh, you're telling me I made the transition. I've not made the transition.
He's telling you.
I know she made the transition. We already discussed it.
Tarana, see, I'm following your footsteps. And thank you.
Tarana, now next you have to also do like radio. It would be good fun. Yeah.
I can't wait to explore that.
Hena, everything should be exciting.
Oh, it's fun. I wanted to ask you something. It struck me well before I even knew we were going to do this interview. I caught a story about nepotism on one of the Bollywood websites. I forget now which one. But they've done an interesting thing. They had like got a collage of actors discussing nepotism. And your point struck out. It struck out in the sense that you said, I can't blame actors who come from acting families for nepotism. It's not their fault. They shouldn't be taking the hit for it.
Yeah.
And they certainly shouldn't be dealing with the negative impact and the, well, social media impact of it. It's what they do. What else do you think they're going to do? And that was interesting. I just want you to expand on that, because for so many people, it's just, but wo to filmi family se hai, uska to banega hi. It's very easy. The rest of us have to struggle. And you're someone who's done the whole grind, but you're still willing to look at it from a different perspective.
Yes. Jaggu, see, the thing is, kisi-kisi ko first break milna aasaan hota hai, kisi-kisi ko nahi hota hai. Lekin asal mein journey shuru tab hoti hai, jab aapki first film release ho jati hai, jab dusri film ki baari aati hai. So, and filmmakers are only going to cast you if you are good as an actor. Sometimes what happens is also the media, the social media, you know, there are people are really interested in what is happening in celebrities' life, in star kids' life. So for media also, you know, when paparazzis, this culture game happened, you know, paparazzi started papping star kids. It's not because the media wanted, it's because what the public wants. So why should we blame the star kids? And I have seen star kids working equally hard. And the amount of pressure they go through, I swear, I feel lucky that I'm not a star kid, because there's camera 24/7 around them. And I believe, agar aap doctor ke paas jaate ho, to aap ye to nahi poochte na ki aapke pitaji bhi doctor the ya nahi. Otherwise, you're a nepotism ka product, and I don't want to eat your medicines. Fair. There are so many aircrafts we board, the pilots, their fathers are also pilots. So we don't say, you know, just because, you know, this is a nepotism kid, this is a star, a pilot.
A star pilot, yeah.
Board this flight. Hmm. Yeah, I mean, I feel like that's very silly. I mean, there are a lot of other issues in our life that we need to deal off. You know, there's a lot of animal cruelty happening. There's a lot of climate things happening. We need to focus more on that, and I feel it's very silly.
I agree with you 100%. Yeah,
we totally agree.
Just goes off track.
We're gonna let you go. We know you're right now in Hyderabad. Firstly, big, big congratulations. This is the first time I'm going to do a Telugu film with another hottie, Dulkar. Oh my God. Like every single girl right now is like, Mrunal has the best luck when it comes to like handsome co-stars. So you're playing, please tell, does it have anything to do with the Ramayana or it's just the way the characters are named? Because you're announced as Sita and he is Lieutenant Ram, right?
Yes. I'm sure Ramayana mein Lieutenant Ram to nahi.
Like, boy to.
It's just the character. And I'm really looking forward to play this character, Sita. It's different. And again, like, I love learning different languages. So Telugu, you know, a lot of fans were curious and the news had already leaked. So finally, we announced it on my birthday. And I think you guys are going to be very proud of me when you watch Sita.
Oh,
watch me as Sita.
We're already there. We're happy to add one more brick to that wall.
Listen, good luck with Jersey. I think, is that going to be your next release with Shahir?
And yes, so we are hoping to release in the month of November. Hoping for this, you know, pandemic and theaters to open up. There is another film called Aankh Micholi with Abhimanyu and Paresh Ji.
That's a fun one. It's a fun comedy. Yeah.
So if you see Love Sonia was very hard hitting, Bartla House was based on a real life story, then we had Super 30, which was about a mathematician, then now Tufan, it's a sports based drama, then we have Jersey and now Aankh Micholi, so it's comedy. So you know, you have like different genre, different roles, different vibe. I think it's my aim is to be a part of movies and not be repetitive. People should be like, oh my God, I didn't believe that it was Mrunal who was playing that role. So,
you're already on that path and every single movie of yours is different from the previous one. So more power to you, darling, upwards and onwards. And you are I will repeat, she is one of the most like humble, lovely, you can make out here. Like with such a beautiful little face, you can't be an evil person or a bad person. With Mrunal, who you see is what you see is what you get.
Is what you
very
get.
Very grounded, very, very down to earth and meant for like bigger and bigger stages in life. You please don't change and good luck. And now go grab your dinner. She hasn't even eaten. Straight from plane into hotel room and she's talked to us. Enjoy your dinner, which is Dal Khichdi.
Yes, which is Dal Khichdi. But I love doing this. Food can wait. Interviews like this happen.
No, food can't wait.
Food can wait because I have literally lived, I have waited for this, this day to arrive. People don't know that this journey took 8 years. People think that 3 saalon mein itne alag alag actors ke saath kaam kiya. But I think in order to reach, I had to work for 8 additional years to be where I am. So literally, I really love my job to an extent where food can really wait.
Oh,
fabulous. Listen, I cannot tell you how thankful we are that you've done this. And it was just so nice talking to you. And I'm hoping that one day, I know you hang with Tarana. And so you call her Madhu Dadi, I call her Madhu Darling. I know you all hang often enough. But inshallah, we will also get the opportunity to meet face to face. So in the meantime, the very best of luck.
Thank you so much, Agu. Thank you, Tarana. It was fun. And I'm happy we could. I'm sorry it took long, but I'm happy it happened.
No. Thank you very much. And good luck and enjoy your dinner.
I can't eat garam because I have stitches. So.
Just stitches in her mouth. And you're shooting tomorrow with stitches in your mouth.
Yes, sir. I don't think we have an option.
We will say it again. Mrunal Thakur, audience to loves her anyway, but producers also, because they're like, baby ko to kuch khane peene ki zarurat nahi hai, time par aati hai, simple hai. There is no baby ke liye juice arriving. Professional always to a fault and just wonderful on screen. You're meant for like the big screen, darling. I'm glad you decided to take that leap.
Thank you so much, Tarana, Jaggu. Hey guys, you must subscribe to Tarana and Jaggu's channel. Like and comment now.
Okay, Mrunal. Okay, bye. Thank you.
Bye. Take care,
my dear. Thank you. Bye, guys. Thank you. Eat dinner. Be safe.
Yeah. You too.
Absolutely.
Give my love to Daddy.
आई विल. शी वाज लाइक वो तो बिल्कुल टाइम पर आएगी, हमेशा टाइम पर आती है. आई वाज लाइक ओके
या बाय बाय.
आई विल प्लीज ईट डार्लिंग. ओके
थैंक्स
बाय.
या बाय.